of a plane down in the area of the Valley Speedway out in Grain Valley in eastern Jackson County. News Chopper 9's Johnny Rollins over that scene right now. Johnny, what do you see?
Well, Chris, we have a Beechcraft Bonanza down here. This is a V-tail Bonanza, an older model Bonanza. They no longer make this particular model of the Bonanza. And it is down in a field in a culvert between a couple of rows of trees. We understand this plane down, the pilot not seriously injured. We're about a mile or a mile and a half to the east of Grain Valley Airport. From what we understand, this airplane departed Grain Valley a little over half an hour ago and ended up, for whatever reason, for some problem in this field. Now, we can tell you that the wind is very strong from the west and southwest. I imagine the departure was to the west, and he may have been circling back to proceed eastbound, but the bottom line is no serious injuries involved with this airplane that's relatively intact. Only one occupant. You can see we do have emergency personnel on the scene, and that is the story from here. Right now, it appears as though everything is normal at Grain Valley Airport. East Kansas City is the official designation. And again, this about a mile or a mile and a half to the east, southeast of the airfield. Johnny Rollins, News Chopper 9, back to you in the studio.
Johnny, even better news, just getting word from the Grain Valley Police Chief that the pilot walked away from the aircraft. Again, that Beechcraft Bonanza taking off from the East Kansas City Airport there in Grain Valley within the last hour. Obviously, some sort of problem. The pilot putting it down in the area of the Valley Speedway, which is located about a mile, maybe a mile and a half, just to the east of the Grain Valley Airport there. And again, the good news is the pilot walking away. That bit of news coming from the Grain Valley Police Chief. We have crews headed that way on the ground as well. Stay with KNBC 9 News and, of course, our website, KNBC.com, for updates on this story throughout the day. And, of course, a full report tonight on KNBC 9 News at 5.